study today. In this video, we are going to learn what is meant by the term industry, and also we are going to see what are the different types of industry. Okay, so first let's see what is meant by industry. Industry is nothing but industry is useful for manufacturing goods. Okay, so what is manufacturing? Manufacturing is nothing but production of goods. Whatever goods we are using, all will be produced by your industry. Okay, so now let's see what are the different types of industries. Okay, so first type of industry is extractive industry. Okay, so what is extractive industry? What does extractive industry means? Okay, see, the name itself is telling, extractive, that means it will extract something. Okay, so what does extractive industry does? It will extract the natural resources. Okay, extractive industry extracts the natural resources. We all know what are natural resources. Okay, soil, oil, petrol, and water. All these are nothing but natural resources. Okay, what are natural resources? Natural resources are something which are naturally created by the earth. Okay, so human cannot produce these natural resources. For example, soil, human can't produce soil. Oil, we can't produce oil. Oil is nothing but petroleum. Petroleum, water, these are all natural resources, and human cannot produce natural resources. Okay, so what does extractive industry does? It will extract all these natural resources such as soil, oil, petrol, water, etc. Okay, so all these products which are extracted by the extractive industry will be used as a raw material for construction and production industries. Okay, so those are next kind of industries which now we are going to learn. Okay, and some other examples of extractive industry is mining. Okay, means gold mining, petrol mining, oil mining, or mining the natural resources. What is mining? Mining means mining the resources from the earth, such as gold mining and oil mining. All these are also example for extractive industry. And next is agriculture. Agriculture is nothing but using the natural resources, we are producing the food, we are producing the crops. So agriculture also comes as a extractive industry. Okay, so agriculture is also one of the example of extractive industry. And other example is fishing. Fishing, we are not producing fishes. Fishes are natural resources, they are already there in the water. Fisherman is just catching the fishes. So fishing is also one of the example of extractive industry. Next is genetic industry. What does genetic industry does? It will reproduce the species. It will reproduce the certain species of plants and animals. Okay, for example, nurseries, poultry. Okay, what is nursery? Nursery is nothing but reproducing the plants. Okay, nursery is nothing but reproducing the plants. Okay, they'll take the human beings will take the existing plants, and with the help of existing plants, they'll reproduce the plants. Okay, so next is poultry. What does poultry mean? Poultry means reproducing the animals. Reproducing animals. Okay, so specially genetic industry is nothing but With the help of existing plants and animals, they will reproduce new animals or new plants. This is nothing but genetic industry. Okay, so next type of industry is construction industry. Construction industry. What is next type of industry? Next kind of industry is construction industry. What is construction industry? See, the name is only telling. Construction industry is concerned with construction of buildings, bridges, dams. Okay, these industries will construct the buildings, dams, buildings, bridges, dams, etc. Okay, so that's why these industries are called as construction industries, because they construct the buildings, bridges, dams, houses, all this. Okay, so these industries is specially involved with the development. Okay, see, they are developing a building, they are developing bridges, dams, etc. Okay, and these construction industries will use the output of the extractive industries as a raw material. Okay, extractive industry is nothing but they will produce oil, petrol, mines, and all, right? So these are the outputs of the extractive industries, and these outputs that they will be used as raw materials in order to construct the buildings, bridges, and dams. Okay, so the outputs of the extractive industry will be used as a input for the constructive industry. Okay, so next kind of industry is service industry. See, the name is only telling, it is this industry provides service. Okay, so the industry which provides multiple various kinds of services are called service industries. Okay, for example, finance, hospitals, banks, libraries, etc. Okay, finance industry. What does finance industry does? Finance industry provides the finance as a service. Okay, so next is hospital. Hospital is also one of the example for service industry, because it will provide the services. Okay, it will provide the doctor. There will be doctors who will treat the patients, so it is also a kind of service. Okay, so next is banks. Banks provides loans. They'll give loans for interest. So all these kind of things are services. That's why bank also comes under service industry. So next is libraries. Okay, libraries is nothing but they'll provide services by renting books, all those kind of things. Okay, industry is main industry is divided into two types. Okay, first is heavy industry, next is light industry. Okay, so what is heavy industry? Heavy industry means it will require huge capital. Okay, huge capital. Okay, and test technology. See, the name itself is saying heavy. Heavy means huge. Okay, so it requires, heavy industries need huge capital, and it needs latest technology, also needs high machinery and equipment. Okay, light industry requires less capital. It requires simple technology. These are the different kinds of industries. And coming to industry, these two are the main classification of industries. Okay, we say that commerce removes hindrances. Okay, so first let's see what is meaning of hindrances. Okay, hindrance is nothing but problems. Now let's see real time example for hindrance. Okay. There is a person. He started from home to school. Okay. In between the road, there is a construction going on. Okay. There is a construction going on. So the road is blocked. So this is a hindrance. Okay. That is, this person is facing a problem in order to reach his destination. Okay. Same way, business also faces few problems. Okay. There will not be a smooth transactions few in a few times, even business will face problems. Okay. So these are called the hindrances. Now let's see how commerce helps in removing all those hindrances. Okay. So first problem is hindrance of place. Okay. Hindrance of place. So first is hindrance of place. Okay. Example, let's think there is a place called Amirpet, and in Amirpet the goods are produced. Okay. Example, let's think there is a manufacturing company which produces wheat, for example. Okay, wheat and rice, but the demand will be overall in India, all over in India. Okay, only the people who stay in Amirpet will not eat rice, right? Everybody all over throughout the India, the food will be consumed. Okay, so here is the production in Amirpet. There is a production, but demand is all through the India. Okay, throughout the India there is a demand. Okay, so now the question is, the products which are produced should be reached throughout the India, all over the India. Commerce came with a solution. What is that solution? The solution is transportation. Okay. So, with the help of transport, the products which are produced at a single place will be traveled throughout India. Okay. So the solution for hindrance of place is transport. With the help of transportation, the products which are produced at one particular place can be traveled and transported throughout the India. Okay. Next is hindrance of time. So let's take the example of sugar. Okay. Sugar is a seasonal product. Okay. Sugar is a seasonal product. It cannot be produced throughout the year. It will be produced only in few months. Okay. Only in few months sugar will be produced. Of course, we all know sugar comes from the sugarcane. The crop of the sugarcane will be only few months. Few months the sugarcane will be grown, and in that few months only the industries will convert sugarcane into sugar. Okay. So this is the simple logic. Okay. Now the question is, the production of the sugarcane is only for few months, but the demand for the sugar will be whole year. Okay. All the 12 months we will consume sugar. It's the manufacturer's responsibility to fulfill the demand. Okay. Always the supply should be equal to demand. Okay. Or the sugar which is produced in few months will be stored in warehouse. Okay. Warehouse. What is this warehouse? Warehouse is nothing but a godown. Okay. Whatever products we will produce in few months, those will be stored in the warehouse. Warehouse is nothing but godown, okay? So whenever we have demand for the products, we can just take the products out of warehouse and we can just use those products, okay? And see, for example, there is a producer, okay? So there is a person called A who is the producer, okay? So he produced some product for 3 months, and after 3 months he has stopped the production, okay? Because whatever he is producing, it's a seasonal product. So after 3 months, what he did is he stored the products in warehouse. So whenever he get the demand, he will just take the products out of the warehouse and he will sell those products like this with the help of warehouse. Even for the seasonal products, we can fulfill the demand for whole year. Okay, so next is hindrance of exchange. Okay, so now let's see what are the hindrances during exchanging. Okay, for exchanging of products. Okay, for example, there are two people called A and B. A is a producer, B is a purchaser. Okay, A is producing the products, B is ready to purchase the products which are produced by A. Okay, so and the cost of the products are A and the cost of the products are one 10,000. Okay, let's take the cost of the products as 10,000. Okay. So this is case one. Okay, so this is case one. This is example one. When a person wants to buy the products, he obviously need to pay the money, pay the cost in exchange, in return. Okay, so when A is giving goods, B must give money or cash in return. Okay, so it is a exchange process kind of a thing. A will give goods, B will give money in return, okay, for the products which B is buying. Okay, here A is giving the goods to B and B in return is giving money to A. Okay, so but here the problem is, in the case one, B have to pay amount of 10,000, but B have only 5,000 with him. Okay, now what he need to do is, he can take the loan of other 5,000 rupees. Okay, here bank comes into the picture. Okay, bank will give the loan of 5,000 rupees to B. Okay, so this is case one. Okay, so in order to overcome the hindrance of the exchange, bank will help in financing. Okay, bank will give the loan of the amount. Okay, what is case two? Okay, in case two, A is a producer, B is a purchaser. A needs to give goods, in return B needs to give money. Okay, but here the question is, A is from US. Okay, A is from America, B is from India. Okay, the money will be counted in the form of dollars in US. Okay, dollars, US dollar. Whereas in India, we will calculate our money in the form of rupees. Okay, so there is a lot of difference in the currency of both the countries. Okay, so now what we need to do is, after buying goods from A, B needs to pay the money. B needs to convert the rupees into dollars. Okay, because in America there will be no rupees, there will be only monetary values in terms of dollars, right? So that's why bank comes into the picture. Okay, bank will help to convert rupees in the terms of dollars. Okay, so like this. In order to overcome the hindrance of the exchange, we need to take the help of the bank. Okay, bank helps to convert the money from dollars to rupees or rupees to dollars like this, we need to take the help of the bank. Okay, so next kind of hindrance is hindrance of knowledge. Take example of some product. Okay, for example, there is a product called A. It is newly launched into the market. Okay, there is a product of A and it is newly launched into the market. Okay, so once it is newly launched into the market, obviously who will purchase A? Consumers will purchase product A, right? But for consumers to purchase the product A, first of all, consumers should know that there is a product called A available in the market, okay? Obviously, consumers will not go to the manufacturing area and they'll not ask, right? So what are the newly launched products in the market? Obviously, it's products manufacturer's responsibility in order to market the product, okay? So the business people, in order to launch the product into the market, they will advertise, okay? We see a lot of advertisements on television, on newspapers, all that, right? So why will they advertise this? With the help of advertisement only, users, that is consumers or customers, will come to know that there is a newly launched product called A into the market. And in advertisement, obviously we should say what are the features of the product, like what are the features of the product. For example, let's think A is a mobile phone. Okay, so for example, let's think A is a newly launched mobile phone. Okay, in the advertisement, first they need to say what are the features. Okay, what is the storage capacity, what is the camera pixels, and what is the other features. Okay, so all those features, first of all, in advertisement the company needs to tell. Okay, next is, second is cost of the product. Whether the mobile is 25,000 or 50,000, obviously the cost of the product also, should be explained in the advertisement. Okay, third one is, where is it available? Where the product is available. For example, let's think consumers are from India and the product is launched in America. Obviously, the customers won't go to America in order to buy the product, right? So, in advertisement, we need to even tell where the product is available, okay? Whether it is India or some other country, all these things which they need to explain in the advertisement, okay? So that there will not be hindrance of knowledge. Now here, with the help of advertisement, we are overcoming the hindrance of knowledge. We are explaining what are the features of the product, what is the product, how it looks like, all those things we are explaining and giving the product knowledge to the users, okay? So next is hindrance of risk. What is hindrance of risk? Obviously, in any business, there will be risk. Okay, we already saw in our previous lectures that when there may be fire risk, like all the products may be caught fire and we may have a great loss. And example, and also other kind of risk is the product is transported from place A to place B, and in middle there may be accident, and let's think all the products are lost, okay? All the products are damaged. So this is also another kind of risk. Fire, accident, and natural calamities. So there will be different kinds of risks involved in our business, okay? So how to overcome this risk is, we need to take insurance. What is insurance? Insurance is nothing but It is a company which will take some premium amount, like, and whenever there is risk involved in the business, such as fire, natural calamities, accident, and when there is a great loss and huge loss for our products, then we can claim the insurance. For example, let's think we have 10,000 products, okay? And in natural calamities, all the 10 products are lost, are damaged, okay? Are completely damaged. Now, what insurance company does is it will help us to claim the damaged amount, okay? It will not pay fully to the 10,000. At least it will pay 60 to 70% approximately, so that at least some of the risk will be overcome, okay? So these are the different hindrances while doing business, and commerce helps us to overcome all these hindrances. Okay, now let's see what is home trade. Okay, home trade is nothing but when the buyer and the seller is within the same country. Okay, for example, let's take India. Okay, if a product is manufactured in India, sold in India, and purchased in India, like when we purchase and sell the goods in the same country, then that trade is called as home trade. Okay, so now let's see what are the different kinds of home trade. Okay, so first kind of home trade is wholesale trade. We all know what is meant by wholesale trade. Wholesale trade is nothing but buying and selling the goods in the bulk amount, in large quantities, in bulk. Okay, so and here wholesaler will be the mediator for manufacturer is also called as producer. Okay, so wholesaler will be the mediator for manufacturer and retailer. Okay, so wholesaler will purchase the products from the producer and he will sell it to the retailer. Okay, so first kind of home trade is wholesale trade. Now let's see what is the second kind of trade. Trade is retail trade. Okay, retail trade is nothing but he will purchase the products in large quantities and sell the products in small quantities. Okay, so retail trader, he will purchase the goods in large quantities and sell the goods in small quantities. Okay, retail trader is also called as retailer. The retailer will purchase the goods from wholesaler and he will sell the goods to final customer, final consumer. Okay, so retailer will be the mediator for wholesaler and final consumer. Okay, retailer is the middleman for wholesaler and final consumer. Okay, so these are the two different types of home trade. So now let's see what are the characteristics of commerce. Okay, so first characteristic of commerce is transportation. Okay, so in one place the products will be produced and throughout the country the products will have demand. For example, let's take rice. Okay, rice will be produced only in few places of the country, but the demand for the rice will be throughout the country. Okay, so now With the help of transportation, products will be transported from one place to other place, okay, in order to fulfill the need of the product, in order to fulfill the demand for the product. So transport is the first characteristic. Second characteristic is warehouse. Warehouse is nothing but the godown, as I already told. Okay, in warehouse, whatever products we produce will be stored in the warehouse. There will be a godown, and in that godown all the products will be stored, and whenever there is a demand for the product, then those products will be taken out from the warehouse and they will be transported and they will be sold out. Okay, so third important characteristic, insurance. Insurance is nothing but whenever there is some fire accident or normal accident or natural calamity, there will be loss of goods. Okay, there will be high risk. In order to overcome that risk, there comes the term called insurance. Okay, normally we will pay some amount to the insurance company regularly, and when there is some fire accident or some other natural calamities, so whatever damage we have for our products, at least some percentage of the damage will be recovered with the help of insurance. Okay, for example, let's think there is a loss of 10,000 rupees worth rupees product. Okay, so at least 50% of the amount can be claimed by the insurance company. Okay, we can take the amount from the insurance company. So next is banking. For example, in order to produce a product, we require 1 lakh rupees. But we don't have that much huge amount with us. We just have some 30,000 with us. Okay, but in order to produce the products, we need 1 lakh rupees. So remaining 70,000 can be taken as loan from the bank. Okay, bank will lend us money, whatever we need to invest in our business, and for that we need to pay the interest. So like that, we can also loan the amount, we can also take the loan from the bank. Okay, last characteristic is advertising. Whatever product we manufacture or whatever product we produce, obviously we need to make sure the final consumer should know about the product which we launched in the market. Okay, because customers only are going to consume our product, customers are only going to buy our product. So it's really important to advertise is nothing but marketing your product, telling the features of the product, telling the cost of the product. All those things can be done through advertisement so that customer will come to have the knowledge about the product. Okay, so these are the different characteristics of the commerce. Okay, so that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also there are other lectures of commerce in the description below. Feel free to watch them as well. So if you have any query, you can feel free to comment in the comment section below. Don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching.